Hello everyone, I am Professor Neeru Mehta from LGU Center of Technology and Engineering. Today we are going to discuss about subject called Automobile System Design, in which today's topic is Design of Braking System. Now let's discuss about braking of a vehicle. Braking of a vehicle is braking is a device, or you can say braking is a system which safeguard your vehicle from any collision or any kind of accident. Now, what brakes create to your vehicle? Brake not only regulate your speed, or you can say maneuverance of your vehicle, but as well as it could help to stop your vehicle. Whether the clutch is a similar device which regulate the speed of a vehicle. So how the clutch and brake will be different from each other? So brake will not only regulate but as well as stop your vehicle, whereas our clutch only regulate your vehicle. So let's discuss about braking. What is braking? When we are driving, or any driver is driving a vehicle, it should always regulate or control the vehicle by the means of acceleration as well as braking. So braking is a part of a controlling of your vehicle. Clear? So this is our introductory session to design of our braking system. So let's discuss about what is a brake. The brake is a device by means of which is artificial friction, like how we are going to control our vehicle, or you can say transfer this regulating or a stopping motion by means of a frictional force. Clear? By stopping our vehicle by applying a frictional force to our moving element. So while applying this frictional force is ultimately convert our kinetic energy into our heat energy, or you can say frictional force. Clear? So this is how your brake or any braking element will going to work. Clear? So how we are going to develop this kind of force, or you can say braking force, in our brake element, that's we are going to discuss in our chapter. In this chapter, we are not only going to design our braking element as well as, but we are also going to design our braking system. A braking element it's not only about to design a shoe brake or a band brake or a disc of that brake, but as well as to design how we are going to control and how we are going to generate that much effort to our vehicle. So there are multiple layers while designing this braking system. We are going to discuss about that braking element, what kind of element we are going to use to brake our vehicle. Second one, what type of braking system we are going to design. And third one, what is end effect of this braking on our vehicle? Like, what is our ultimate stopping distance, or what could be our required stopping distance, or what could be the effect of a braking while we are driving on a slope or anywhere like a turning, taking turn. That's are the different criteria which we are going to discuss in this particular chapter. So here I have shown a schematic diagram of a braking system. This is hydraulic braking system which have drum brake and disc brake contained here. Clear? As you know that the brake or you can say braking requires effort which is generated by. First of all, I will explain the system in this particular schematic diagram. The system here, you can see it's hydraulic system which is controlled by brake pedal. Then this brake pedal effort due to this leverage will converted or will generate pressure inside the master cylinder. This master cylinder distribute this pressure via distributor to front and rear wheel axle, and ultimately this will actuated by the end effector, or you can say end component, with whether it could be a drum brake or a disc brake. Clear? So let's discuss about one by one how this system works. Then we will going to discuss about what amount of effort we are going to require for a front and a rear wheel braking system. So when we are applying this brake pedal, it will generate pressure inside the master cylinder. This pressure will generate our system with the help of, or you can say by Pascal's law, it will generate same amount of pressure inside a whole system. But as you know that front wheel and rear wheel requires different amount of efforts. As our rare wheel comes under or it is comes near the center of gravity of vehicle, it will require lesser force or lesser effort compared to our front wing. Clear? So we will have effort to our front and rear wheel. So ultimately we will provide different distribution of effort in our front and rear wheel while designing this braking system. So to design this different effort to front and rear wheel, we will provide two distributor to front and another distributor to the rear wheel. Here the cross section, because the pressure inside the system will be the same. So how could you generate different effort? So by applying different or by having different cross section area to the front wheel distributor and the rear wheel distributor, we can achieve different amount of effort to the front wheel as well as rear. I hope you understand this point in the case of hydraulic braking system. If it is mechanical braking system, then the length of our lever which actuates our front and rear wheel axle will be the different. And if it is a pneumatic system, then there should be a different actuator. The same goes for same here as hydraulic system will go into applicability. I hope you understand what is the basic function or basic criteria for to design this braking system. Clear? Now, if our question is whether to use disc brake or a drum brake, it is depending on application or depend on our vehicle, what type of vehicle we are using here. Clear? So that is our major criteria to selecting our drum brake or a disc brake. Let's move on to the design capacity. Okay, what is the our design capacity depend on the different factors. Clear? So the unit pressure between the braking surface, what amount of braking pressure, braking or pressure we are going to require for a particular surface, whether it is drum brake or a disc brake. So we are going to determine this pressure for our surface. Second one, the coefficient of friction, what type of material we are using to between those two surfaces which are matting and creating this braking force. Then the peripheral velocity, what type of velocity or what amount of velocity it is come under the drum or a disc. Clear? The projected area of frictional surface, the frictional surface with projected area over them, and the ability of the brake to dissipate the heat equivalent, what amount of heat energy it can dissipate. Here you can see our drum brake, design of drum brake in which we are putting a pressure inside that drum and they will open it up. Clear? And the area will become under which we have discussed here, and ultimately that drum and the shoe on that drum will create that frictional force and ultimately stop your moving or revolving element. Clear? What kind of type of brake we are going to design in the case of our sub chapter? So hydraulic brake, first we are going to design hydraulic brake. Clear? It will also have same drum brake and disc brake. Clear? But the system is hydraulic system. Clear? Second one, electric brake, same thing applied over here. We can use a drum brake or disc brake, but it can be actuated by means of electromagnetic force, and ultimately our old mechanical brakes which also have a drum or a disc brake. Clear? Here you can see the this is the hydraulic system, or you can say the braking fluid. Here you can say braking fluid, which is generate pressure over our disc, which is revolving, which is connected to our drive. This second one is electric brake system, in which our electric motor which creates that eddy currents. I will explain this eddy current and eddy phenomenon in detail while we are designing this electric brake. And third one, this mechanical brake, which is actuated with the help of lever mechanism. So let's once again discuss about this. Here we have three different systems, but our end effector could be the same. I hope you understand my point. Clear? End device or end component could be a drum, disc, or a shoe brake, but the system could be different in the case of different types of our requirement. I hope you understand this point. The next, this book, this chapter, I will going to dictate will be from this. You can refer machine design by R.S. Kurmi or auto design by R.B. Gupta. I hope you understand each and every point of this introductory session of our braking system. Let's revive each and every point of this braking system. From the first point, first we have set up a definition for our brake. Brake is an element which can be regulate or stop stop your motion of a vehicle. Here we will have we could have those elements clear or component to have that braking or stoppage in our vehicle. It could be a drum brake or it could be a disc brake. Second one, what type of factors which affect your braking system? It could be a pressure, it could be a coefficient of friction, it could be a peripheral velocity of a drum and projected area of the surface. Clear here, as well as the ability to absorb that heat and dissipate. Not only absorbing the heat, but as well as it has to dissipate the heat. Clear? And then what types of brake system here, not only this brake, but braking system, which we are going to use hydraulic braking system, electrical braking system, as well as mechanical braking system we can use. In hydraulic braking system, the hydraulic fluid, which is pressurized with the help of lever, and by following the Pascal's law, it will generate pressure, or you can say a braking force on our braking element. Here you can see the hydraulic system or hydraulic braking system. Then electric braking system generates eddy current which disrupt or which interrupt a motion of our revolving element with the help of our device, which it could be disc brake or a drum brake. And ultimately mechanical braking system, we will use lever mechanism to generate that braking force in our brake. Clear? Okay, I hope you understand these points very well. Each and every point I have dictated, which will going to be in your GTU examination, as well as it will also be in our mid-semester exam. I hope you understand each and every point very well. Clear? In next chapter, we are going to design our mechanical, or you can say mechanical braking system with our end devices. Thank you so much. I am stopping here. If you have any doubt regarding to this point or any doubt regarding to this a particular video, you can directly ask me. Thank you. Thank you.